red dust clear. I am on the red rock. Stands the shadow with the spear. Stands the shadow with the spear.
I began getting back into songwriting. You can keep my things, they're gonna take me home.
One song on Gabriel's third album was Biko, about Steve Biko, the black leader who died in a South African prison in 1977. It began with a chant sung at Biko's funeral.
And they perhaps have different instruments which are like pieces of a jigsaw which form a pattern, a whole, which an individual part cannot provide you with. So, and I think the variation and the range is much more stimulating. In a lot of rock and disco, there's this very heavy, tight bass drum and backbeat from the snare. And this is the foundation for most of the music that you'd hear in a disco, for instance. And yet there are rhythms which are just as exciting to the body, that are just that create the same sort of responses, but are much more imaginative and open.
Gabriel's work on his new album began with a search for interesting rhythms. When we first visited him at his studio near Bath, he'd already spent many months seeking out and listening to music from all over the world. This included Aborigine, Caribbean and Latin American music, as well as African drumming.
I don't believe that I can play music belonging to another culture. Just there will be certain key elements which I will steal to start off as a structure for something that I'm working on. And I think if you look at the history of music, you see this process going on continuously. And for me, it's something which sets up a whole series of challenges, and I think has revitalized what I do in my own life.
This case here, which has got the entire assembly of various cassettes, and so some will have been from bits heard on the radio, some will have been from bits on records that friends have given me or that I've come across in shops. There was a couple of things which I got my handheld cassette machine stuck to the telly. I think there were a couple of World About Us programs, and they had something in Swaziland and Bali, and but I think this was something, some Ghanaian thing which I stole a rhythm from. It's me picking out a rhythm underneath. Scouts and guides may power our sights.
At this point, in the spring of 1981, Gabriel was expecting to have his new record ready for release that autumn. In fact, it would take more than another year of painstaking work to complete the album. It would consume over £122,000 in recording costs, on top of the money, about £100,000, he spent on building and equipping his own studio. We followed Gabriel throughout the recording process. The first step was to see how he brought the sophisticated technology of the studio to bear on his suitcase full of rhythms.
I'm certain the third world is going to have an increasing influence on our culture. And in music, a very vigorous hybrid will be produced, which is based on this non-European and new technology, which is going to get very, very cheap. And this facility will open up a new range of electronic skill.
Well, hi there.
Initially, when you first come into the studio, it's like walking into another world of massive buttons, which are totally foreign. And as you spend more and more time in the studio, Sebo, steel, uses as the basis for my song. For instance, put one up here in the machine, which is good for quite a simple rhythm that I can use it to illustrate what I do. When I've got my rhythms locked into the drum machine, I begin improvising normally, and often the rhythm will suggest type of sound that I should use on synth or whatever, and then these ideas would be formed around the rhythm. And the process then is to start developing these ideas and rhythms, which I mean, there's probably over 100 starting points on this album, and a lot of these get knocked by the wayside, and then the best of these shall then begin developing. For instance, there's something I'm working on at the moment which is taken from Ethiopian folk music, and this I found very disturbing. It just goes on with these intervals, repeating them endlessly. So I know I took those intervals and began writing some music around them.
On pipes. And gradually this rhythm would emerge up underneath it. This is the second rhythm, which has been faded in after we get to the chord change at the end of the first.
Once I've got some of the rhythm and melody ideas, the next thing I have to do is make a rough recording so that I can play this to the musicians who will be arriving very soon to start work with me. And normally, I go through this process on my own. This new album I've been working with, the guy who I'm going to be doing the producing with, called David Lord.
Quite shortly before the musicians arrive, the songs are very much fragments. What we've been trying to do is piece these fragments together. In fact, we've demoed the songs ourselves, just him and me and a rhythm machine, so that really we've got a shape, a structure to play the musicians. In fact, I think the structure is usually the main thing. All the ideas, it's well in the music of the song.
While working on the basic song ideas, Gabriel was also compiling a library of sounds which he might use on the album. For this, he used a computerized instrument called a phaser. Any sound can be fed into it, stored, and played back on its keyboard.
See, if I pick up this mic, for example, and press S for sample, you can put in the sound, I hope. Over here we have the mummy, the waveform, and it should be up on the keyboard. I hope to use the fill and give myself the usual soundscapes, which I'm going to try and make sure. On to the windscreen, take one.
I'm in contact.
good. Yeah, all the sounds on this thing are stored on these floppy disks, and some of these are supplied with the machine. This has a list of all the different sounds available on this floppy disk. So I pull out my phallic symbol here and point it at the appropriate noise. Say this is Pet Swan, which is a modified Swanee whistle. There's a repeat built into it, and the rhythm of the repeat is something which really really excited me, and I've written a song around the rhythms. So there, I was thinking of a rhythm that would go against it. At this point, I've only got outline ideas for lyrics, so I use odd sounds and noises from the voice, which I call Gabriel. I think often that the making sound of the voice is more emotive without lyrics, and I intend there to be less lyrics. Trying to enlarge what I do with my voice, not through technique, but through just the sounds. I think we all make noises, and particularly when we get involved or emotional about something, colors and tones of those noises change. And the same black music, they're all represented, so you get these guttural noises which are very much built into the rhythms and to the atmosphere of the whole and the tension and excitement of it. Whereas, say, in opera, you have this very abstracted form of singing through a brilliant technique often, but for me as a listener, it doesn't have the emotional impact that I get when I listen to a brilliant song. And I think in rock as a whole, there have been many great songs really appealing words. There have been no great songs which have had appealing music. So I think there's one, that priority as well. But if you're going to write lyrics, you might as well make them as potent as you can and try and communicate something.
The first ideas for lyrics were jotted down in this book. Your lyrics drew me back into the psychologist. Well,
overwhelms him, and he's so terrified by the thing that he stops the drums, and all the drums away, and has to pay for them to move apart, and they seem free. Powerful, powerful. You will be a pivotal figure of the mind. Over.
when you get the big scream, it's probably the point at which Jung goes into the dancers and really becomes frightened. And otherwise, he's still playing around with the lyrics, and the melody's very much improvised at this point.
After Gabriel and David Lord had recorded rough versions of about a dozen possible songs, the other musicians started to arrive, and the material was reworked as they added their part.
I asked Gary Moore.
Feel that emotion, because that's basically what music is all about, is expressing an emotion inside of you. The machine and I split the work 50-50, you know. We both work very hard.
The other musicians come so that we can get the backing tracks recorded. These are essentially the basic instrumental. One method is for each musician to lay down their part separately on a track, and I can have full control to mess around with it later.
The next musician to arrive was bass guitarist Johnny Levin.
Called a stick, and I play it as a bass.
I have very much to try and accept his idea. once it's alright in the can. Is that right, Mark?
Get rid of the old drum. No, you haven't.
Do one without the drum.
If we have hang-ups, what I like to do is to keep the music fresh, is sort out all the problems. Everything sounds good. It's great.
With the musicians on their drum, bass and guitar parts went on for several weeks. When this part of the process was over, Gabriel had amassed 27 16-minute tapes, over 7 hours of material. There were now different versions of 18 possible songs, several of which were running at over 10 minutes.
Sat in the corner of the garden grill with the plastic flowers on the windowsill. No more miracles, the fishes been so busy with the white.
When the backing tracks had been recorded, Gabriel and Lord worked for 3 months with Larry Fast, a specialist in electronic instruments. They added to and subtracted from the songs, employing all the technology available to play with the sounds already recorded and to search for entirely new sounds.
Some of the records that I enjoy most have had their own oral world, their own particular sound, and I try to create that in what I do.
We will try treating sounds, put them in perspective in this picture that we're building up. So, for instance, if you have, say, a fat keyboard sound that you think is occupying too much space and has too much weight and depth to it, I may stick it through something to make it thin and wavy, so that I think it's a personality is the word I would use. It's personality changes.
Electronic instruments, in the way that we have approached them on this album, become totally integrated into the recording process. The way the drums would be processed or saxophone parts, anything else will at times go through the electronics and then be blended in with newer sonic textures, sound qualities, just expanses of sound.
The mixing process for me is often a case of eliminating material. And say in Rhythm of the Heat, which used to be called Here in Africa, the guitar's been dropped all together because I thought it was a much too familiar reference. Doesn't really matter if
if the end product works.
We've reels and reels, mountains of reels, roses, triacts and overdubs, and lines and different musicians coming in trying things. And actually, when you get down to the final notes, very often very little of that is you. But that's a sort of compositional process, really. Some people would go through it before they go to the studio, but most of people work in that direction happens in the studio.
I have here some very atmospheric samples, and I'm trying emptying everything else out of the track at the end of San Jacinto, except for this, because I think it sort of crystallizes the mood better than anything else. And this is from one of the scrapyards, a lone drain pipe. But if I put it into a small repetitive sequence, I think it sets up
were rewritten and revised many times before they reached their final version.
In San Jacinto, I was trying to get the picture of the clash of cultures between this artificial white world of swimming pools, golf courses, Frank Sinatra, which has been sort of stuck on top of the desert landscape, and then the San Jacinto mountain towers above there. And yet just around the corner, of the Indian canyons and the Indian reservations, and the mountain was for them a holy mountain. So there is there this sense of the American Indian and their relationship to the world in which they lived in, the natural elements. And so in San Jacinto, there's the attempt for this one man to find this and to hold on to his line of instinct, and not be seduced into this world which increasingly is moving around him.
Oh! my sight. I hold the line. Your mind is working out of detail. Your assumes it's strong. Hold on. I think I'm losing it.
I feel often in conversation inarticulate, and if I have time, which I do on lyrics, to go through, hone it down word by word, measure by measure, then I feel I can get exactly what I want.
Last July, Gabriel played a considerable part in inspiring and organizing the World of Music, Arts and Dance Festival, which brought together musicians and dancers from all over the world. Festival that he chose to perform his new song live on stage for the first time.
Thank you.
is that I'm getting played on black stations in America. And even though in the white press I got some fair slaggings this time, I had a very good review in sort of black music magazine. And even though I don't think my music has much in common with main black music, it's still a great for me to feel that the rhythm content is strong enough to get through to black people. There are definitely elements of this album which are a progression for me. I want to continue exploring this hybrid between electronic or high-tech and non-European influence. And I think a lot more rock musicians are now working in this area, and there will be a style of music to emerge in the 80s, which I think will be very important and influential.